Jesus, keep me from all wrong. I as I walk, let me walk close to thee. Through this world that's torn and snared, if I falter, Lord, would you hear? None but thee, dear Lord, none but thee. Just a closer walk with thee. Friend, if Jesus is my plea, daily walking close to thee. Let it be, dear Lord, let it be. When my feeble life is o'er, time for me will be no more. Guide me gently, safely home. To my theme, from shore to my shore. Just a closer walk with thee. Friend, if Jesus is my plea, daily walking close to thee. Let it be, dear Lord, let it be. Let it be, dear Lord, let it be.
Oh, Russ has a beard. Yeah, you know, he's sort of, he's working on the rest, isn't he? Oh, my. Well, anyway, we're going to have some cold refreshments afterwards, I think, is the idea. So, but anyway, y'all come on out and let's enjoy the evening together. Well, it's good to have you. I thank you for being with us today. We have a few folks that's gone on vacation right in the middle of July. A few of our people are very ill. We love them, miss them. But thank the Lord you're here. And thank the Lord for those people who will join us later by way of YouTube. And let me say concerning our YouTube ministry, that is a great ministry that we began a couple of years ago. And of course, you know, you can get onto YouTube by just saying, "Hey Siri, YouTube Messiah Baptist Church, Richland Hills," all you have to do. Or like what Jody got me for Father's Day, she got me these business cards, and on the back is that little QR thing. So it was pretty neat. You just take a picture of that and it shows up anytime. So, and I'm mentioning that because I think our YouTube ministry is worth a while, and I'd like to see it just continue to flourish and grow and have more and more people tune in. I had a friend of mine who said last week that she listened to Brother Ron and I sing 10 times. And I said, "Man, that entertainment up in that area is not too much, you know?" But anyway, it was a blessing to have them say that. Our God offers help all the time. Our God offers help. God is good part of the time?
All the time.
God offers help both today and tomorrow.
One moment.
Oh, my. See, I said it, and there she's talking to me. That's funny. I won't mention her. Don't mention her name again. Her name is Siri. She talks to me. Tells me what to do. But I've got a good message for us today. It's, I listened to a little bit of it this morning. Y'all remember, if you remember back in the 60s and 70s, y'all remember that song, "I Can See Clearly Now"? Y'all remember that song? That's kind of what this message is about. I can see clearly now. Open your Bibles with me to the book of Mark. Chapter 8, I can see clearly now. I feel sorry for anybody who has never felt the touch of God upon their life. Probably all of us here, somewhere along the path of our life, the Lord touched our heart. And it is a wonderful thing to have the Lord touch you. In Mark chapter 8, verse 22, I'll begin reading there. Just read a few verses to us. Hope to be a blessing to you. "And he cometh," Jesus cometh, "and he cometh to Bethsaida, and they bring a blind man unto him and besought him to touch him. And he took the blind man by the hand and led him out of the town." Look at this, Russ, look at the words. "And when he had spit on his eyes," remember that? "And put his hands upon him. And he asked him if he saw aught." That word means, can you see clearly? Can you see clearly? Verse 24, "And he looked up and he said, I see men as trees walking. After that, he put his hands again." And that's an important word to the message today. "He put his hands on him again, upon his eyes, and made him look up, and he was restored." And look what it says, "and he saw every man clearly." He saw every man clearly. First, he could see, but he couldn't see clearly. The first touch, he could see, but he couldn't see clearly. The Lord touched him again, and he could see clearly. That's the message. There is nothing too hard for the Lord to do for you. There is nothing too hard for the Lord to do for you. I do not know what you may be going through or what you may be experiencing, but I can assure you there is nothing too hard for the Lord to do just for you. Throughout the New Testament, you can read of 37 different miracles performed by Jesus. We know he performed a lot more, but as far as recorded miracles, there are 37. I suppose, like John said, if everything was written that should be written or could be written, the world could not contain the books that should be written. Jesus touched the multitudes. In just a few verses earlier in that same chapter, that's the story of Jesus feeding the 5,000. That's quite a miracle in itself. So Jesus touched the multitudes. But here he touches one man. Each and every time that he touched someone, their life would be changed for the better. It was always for the better for that individual. The Lord could help them, whatever their need may be. He could heal the leper. He can heal the broken heart. And he can heal all manner of diseases. Is that true?
Amen.
All a person had to do was touch the hem of his garment. Or like the centurion, just simply believe. For all things are possible to him or to her that believes. Let me ask you this question. Has Jesus ever touched your life? Has Jesus ever touched your life? And did it make a difference in your life when you felt the touch of the Lord upon your life? Besides getting ready to come to church this morning, getting dressed, getting a shower, and coming to church, besides doing all that, to come, to worship, to praise the name of Jesus, to sing songs and to give our offerings, and to serve our Lord, perhaps we have come today because we need a touch from the Master's hand. Perhaps God can still perform a miracle. I'm glad I come to church today. You never know what the Lord's going to do when you get there. If you need Jesus to touch your life, like he did years ago when he saved you, you may need a miracle today. You may need a miracle to restore your family. Oh man, when you start your family, oh, everything's so great and wonderful, but sometimes problems come. Difficulties arise. And now you need a second touch from the Lord to help you to restore your family. You need a miracle to restore your marriage. You need a miracle to restore your children and your family. You may even desire a touch from the Master's hand. Like the blind man in our text, the first touch was good, but the second touch was even better. And I thought, well, what does that mean exactly? And in my little brain, I said, you know, it was a good thing when I got saved, and I remember when I got saved. But you know, the Lord, that's not all there is to it. Getting saved was a big point, a big part of my life. But there's more to it than that. Maybe you have come today seeking a miracle. For he that began a good work in you, whenever that was, he that began a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ, till he comes again. What a day that will be. Perhaps he will restore our life, our health. Maybe all we need to do is ask. Wasn't it Jesus who said these words that told us, you have not because you ask not? You might not leave here the same as when you came if you'll just ask Jesus. God may give you new hope, a new vision. Because, my friend, there is nothing too hard for the Lord to do just for you. Now, I know, sometimes we pray and it seems like it takes a long time, right, Jeanette? But I'm going to believe the Lord until my dying day. Live or die, we are the Lord's. We will serve Him and we will honor Him. Today, as we listen to God's word, we will determine, we will make this determination that we will not leave here the same as when we came. There's an old song, Brother Glenn. There's an old song, if you remember Brother Aubrey. Brother Aubrey's already with the Lord. And I heard you sing this song. But Brother Aubrey, this is the first song I ever heard Aubrey sing back in 1968. Brother Aubrey sang this song. Oh, he touched me. Oh, the joy that floods my soul. Something really happened. And now I know he touched me and made me whole. Thank God for the touch of Jesus upon your life. Thank God for the gospel preaching church that's still preaching the word. Amen. With all of her human flaws, with all the problems and difficulties that the church may have, she still preaches Jesus. Amen. And she still believes that he's able to work miracles. I heard it said there's power in the name. I heard it said there's power in the blood. I heard it said that there's power in prayer. The lost world focuses in on all the church's weaknesses. And they can only see the negative part of the pastor. Oh, and they see all the negative things of its members. And I just say, surprise, none of us are perfect. No excuse, we simply aren't perfect. But aren't you glad Jesus paid it all? Amen. Every sin had to go neath the crimson flow. I think it said, as far as the east is from the west, so far hath he cast our sins from us. He's hidden them behind his back where no man can find them. Simply stated, Jesus paid it all. And that touch changed our lives. The world sees the negatives, but the church has a lot of positives too. She cares for the poor. She cares for the orphans. She prays for the sick. She gives food to those who are hungry. She gives gifts. The church, if you've been around this church very long, we're going into our 37th year this January, 37 years. And for 36 of those 37 years, we've given gifts at Christmas time to all the children. 36 years. For all those years, we've supported those missionaries that you see on the board there. We've cared for them. In fact, we had a missionary come by this morning asking us to help them in their work in Ghana, South Africa. That's what we do. The church helps to support the poor and help the weak. We help to restore families and help to restore marriages. My dear friend, I'm glad to tell you that God is still in the miracle working business. And sometimes in our life, we need a second touch to get our lives going in the right direction once again, so that we can focus in and be clear of what we're doing and who we're serving. And so I say, why not ask the Lord for a miracle? Why not ask Him for help today? I've had people say to me along the way, Brother Paul, my life, my family, my children, even my health is so messed up, I can't see how God could ever help me. Well, that's why we call it a miracle. When everyone else has given up, God is still able. Faith is the substance of things hoped for. Faith is the things that can build mountains. Faith can close the mouth of a lion. Faith can cure cancer. Faith can cure COVID. Faith can restore your home and your health and your finances. And faith can restore your soul. But remember, faith without works is dead. I heard an old-time preacher say, some of those old-time preachers knew what they were saying. I heard an old-time preacher say, believe like it all depends on you. Pray like it all depends on God. Sometimes life will hand you a lemon. And when it does, it's time for God to make some lemonade. Moses was 40 years old the very first time that God spoke to him. 40. He would not hear from the Lord again until he was 80. And then he heard from the Lord at the burning bush. Most of you have heard of that story. 80 years old when he had the burning bush experience. The point being, you're never too old for God to work a miracle in your life. Amen. Neither are you too young. He will touch your life over and over and over again. Just because things didn't work out the first time, don't give up. Keep trying. Try every day if you have to. A good man, according to Solomon, will stumble many times. And every single time, God will help him back on his feet. Peter, who was a disciple of the Lord. He was a disciple, a devout follower of Christ. But when the pressure was on, the night that Jesus was betrayed, Peter cursed and denied even knowing Jesus. But the very next day, he would repent. He needed a second touch. And one day, just a few weeks later, Peter, the one who denied even knowing the Lord, would preach on the day of Pentecost, and 3,000 people would come to know the Lord as their Savior. One of the saddest people that you will ever meet, and I've met a few, one of the saddest people that you will ever meet is the Christian who has turned and walked away from the Lord and walked away from their calling. My dear friend, there is nothing too hard for the Lord to do for you. He can satisfy, and no one can satisfy the human heart, the human soul, like Jesus. No one. No one but Jesus. Here's a little poem I have written down. It's called The Touch of the Master's Hand. It was battered and scarred, and the auctioneer thought it hardly worth his while to waste his time on the old violin. But he held it up with a smile. What am I bid, good people, he cried. Who starts the bidding for me? $1? Who'll make it two? $2? Who'll make it three? $3 once, $3 twice. Going, but no. From the back of the room, a gray-bearded man came forward and picked up the bow. Then, wiping the dust from the old violin and tightening up the strings, he played a melody, pure and sweet as the angels sing. The music ceased, and the auctioneer, with a voice that was quiet and low, said, "What now am I bid for this old violin?" As he held it aloft with its bow, 1,000, 1,002, do I hear 3? 3,000, once, 3,000, twice, going, going, gone. The audience cheered, but some of them cried, "We don't understand what changed its worth." Swift came the reply, "The touch of the master's hand." And many a man with his life out of tune, all battered and bruised with hardship, is auctioned cheap to a thoughtless crowd, much like the old violin. A mess of pottage, a glass of wine, a game, and he travels on. He's going once, he's going twice, he's almost gone. But the master comes, and the foolish crowd never can quite understand the worth of a soul and the change that is wrought by the touch of the master's hand. Let us determine today that we will not leave here the same as when we came. Let our prayer be, "Lord, touch me one more time. Let me feel the sense of the touch of the master's hand." You're never too old, you're never too young, and you're never too messed up to feel the touch of the master's hand.
Amen.
Lord, send a revival. Send it through me. Let it begin right here. Somebody said, and I've heard this said, people say all the time, "I wish it was like the good old days." But you know, the good old days were pretty good. But I think God has something even better for us in the future.
Amen.
He has a better plan. Just like the sermon, I heard somebody say this a long time ago. Y'all remember Johnny and Pauline Bates?
Yes.
Couple. They get up here and sing. And Johnny said this, and I believe this about the work of the Lord, and I believe this about our church. Johnny would get up here and he sang this song on the fifth Sunday night singing, church singing we used to have. Johnny and Pauline get up here, an older couple. They're both with the Lord now. But Johnny would say this, it'd be the last couple, and he'd say, "Don't put your forks up. The best is yet to come." And that's what I say about the work of the Lord. We've had good sermons. We've had good things happen all along the way. But God has good plans for us. And so my admonition is this as we leave. Be not weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. Let us pray. Father, I thank you for all that you've done for us. I thank you for the touch in our life. I remember, Lord, when you touched my life as a 17-year-old boy, you saved me. And what a wonderful evening that was. But Lord, you had many more things to do and in my life. And through the years, I know you've touched my life many times. And I know you've done the same for most of these folks. But sometimes, Father, we need a special touch just so we can see things a little more clearly. And just as this blind man, he could see when the Lord touched him the first time. But when the Lord touched him the second time, he could see clearly. So I'm asking you, Lord, to be with us today. May we follow you. You said, you taught us, Lord. You said, "My sheep hear my voice. I know them and they follow me." So let us keep our focus on you, on what you want us to do. And let the joy of the Lord be our strength in the days ahead. If there's someone here today whose home needs a special touch. Would you do that? If there's someone here today struggling financially, would you help them, Lord, get a better job? Lord, if there's someone here who has children, who has gone out of the way, Lord, I pray that you would be with them, touch them, and bring them back. Like the prodigal, let them come home again. Thank you for our church. Thank you for all you've done for us. Be with our folks. May your will be done. In Jesus' holy name I pray. Amen. Amen. Stand and sing with us a couple of verses of invitation. What number do you have, Brandon?
341. Lord, I'm coming home.
Lord, I'm coming home. What